keep on rushing. Faster, faster, quicker than the next man. To be the best is the master plan. Go on with all you got, give it your best shot. Don't ever think about trying to stop. Keep reaching, pushing, hoping for perfection. Make up your direction. Don't ever stop for a moment. Prove you want it, if you got it, flaunt it, and get up on it. Go for yours, not for a minute, but all the time. You better do it, cause I'm going for mine. Listen closely and you'll get lifted. Higher than you ever been before. Getting more than you're bargained for sure. Life can be a trip full of trouble, but you gotta stand up and fight back double. Don't let nothing hold you back, yo. When life says stop, you say go, go. Reaching, growing, teaching, knowing. Instead of preaching to each and every one of you, I'm flowing. Get yourself together, keep moving. Don't let nothing stop your flowing. Go for what you want, don't hold back. Cause I know you got the knack to go farther than you've ever been.
Oh, I'm fire. I see. got a new tour. I'm going insane, starting a hurricane, releasing pain. Letting you know you can't gain or maintain unless you say my name. Ripping, killing, digging and drilling a hole past the old goal. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. Shotgun blasts are heard when I rip and kill at will. The man of the hour, tower of power. I'll devour. I'm gonna tie you up and let
Now, hey, I want another score right now. I want to tell you, right down the field and milk the clock and just daggone take it to them now. You got to go hard. Look for them stunting. Let's go on three. On three, don't jump. On three. On three, don't jump. The play's away from you. You ain't got nothing to jump for. Let's go. Let's go. Let's see how tough they are. Let's see how tough they are. Let's go front right, 26 power.
I think it's just a busted play. Eric Overby loses a couple of yards. Third down coming up. Here's some booing.
Well, there's one thing about these Rosewood fans, man. They stay on top of the game, and they don't mind giving you applause, and they don't mind booing if they don't like that play. And they did not like that play. Yeah.
Jeff Vernon going in. Reed Lewis back in. Third down and five. Full house backfield for the Rosewood Eagles. And Erickson, let's try a pass again. He fires it long. He's going to be up there. He's caught.
No, he dropped it. Couldn't hang on. Once he hit the ground, he could not hang on. Could not hang on.
Fourth down and five.
But I tell you what, he's lucky because he got away with a push.
He did.
I mean, Whitley.
I really wasn't going to say that.
Well, you got to call it like it is, like you see it. And Whitley pushed off. So that was a tough break. And speaking of Whitley, he is going back to do the punting. for Rosewood, and there's nobody back yet. Finally, Jerome Knight, number 80, drops back deep for the Red Barons. It's a bad snap.
Gets
Whitley
it
does
off.
A good job.
And it takes a nice Rosewood bounce inside the 10-yard line down at the 5. So a great break. However, there is a flag on the play, and I think it's probably going to be an illegal procedure. We'll wait and see what the count on the flag is. Let me see if we can see that push you were talking about just a moment ago in Whitley. He fires it, and I think maybe, yeah, there was a push just before the ball got there.
Pushed off.
Yeah.
Well, you had a procedure penalty against Rosewood. They'll have to punt it again.
And they had that ball right at the 5-yard line.
I mean, that was a nice punt by Whitley.
Yeah. So, Whitley, how about giving us another one just like that? And we'll tell you about Builders Discount Center with locations in Wendell, Wallace, Rocky Mount, and Burlington. Suppliers of all your building needs at discount prices. And they'd like to congratulate the players and the coaches, of course, the band and the cheerleaders, and, of course, all the loyal fans of the Rosewood Eagles. Hey, Curtis. People is counting on you there. Boy, get it away. Good shot.
Oh, nice kick.
And he'll try to run it back. It takes a bad bounce. And fortunately, the Red Baron managed to hold on to it. Or Rose would have had the ball at the 15-yard line.
Yeah, because Wayne Boswell was right on top of that.
Yeah. That's a funny-shaped pumpkin, isn't it?
I mean, it is. We're down to 4:29. And, of course, Rosewood is on top 8-6. Rosewood took the opening kickoff and just drove straight down the field. And the Red Baron score has come in with a pass interception. So far, I would say that Rosewood has basically dominated
the
game.
And, of course, without that interception, it would be an 8-zip ball game with ease. First and 10, and with the ball, and a big opening up the middle. A good pickup of 15 yards up to the 35-yard line. It's number 40, Joseph Barrow. That's the best offensive play that the Gates County Red Barons have put on the field tonight. Hopefully it's the last.
Yeah, no sooner than we say that Rosewood dominated, they boom with a 15-yarder.
They don't have to do that again.
Nope, they sure do not.
3 minutes, 57 seconds to go in the first half. If you just tuned in, where you been? It's 8-6 Rosewood over Gates County, first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Quarterback keeper. And Devane Harvey manages to pick up almost 5 yards. It'll be second, and let's call it a short 6 from where he was brought down. And Gates County is warming up, which is not a good sign.
No, not a good sign at all, but they're a good ball club. You don't get this far and not be a good ball club. The News and Observer has said that both of these teams are Cinderella teams. And
I don't know about
either,
that.
Either one
really
of them.
I don't think they're Cinderella teams. I really don't. And he's going to be stopped after a gain of about 2 yards.
I didn't ask you what you thought. I was just
telling
you.
Well, I was making my
But as
comments.
Usual, you didn't let me finish. So where are we now?
Are you finished?
I am now.
He got a first down out of that, and I'm not really sure how. I did not
well,
think he got that
Well, you
far.
Were trying to run your mouth
no,
while I was trying
no,
to talk.
No,
Webster.
No. I'll not work with you. 3:02 and counting, and with the ball, it's loose on the ground, and it looks like Rosewood has recovered.
Well, let's see who comes up with that ball. That was number 23, John Reese. And I'm telling you.
Well, it just laid on the ground for the longest kind of time. Hey, fellas, you in the truck, how about switching over and let's see that play again? There's a ball on the ground right there. It just lays there, and boom.
I was afraid they're going to try to pick it up and not get it, so just jumping on it.
Good break for the Rosewood Eagles, and they've got the ball in Red Baron territory at the 38-yard line, first and 10, and the ball goes on an end around to number 89, Wayne Boswell. Boswell picks up the first down. 10-yard run on that end around.
Well, I'll tell you what he did. He just tight-roped down that sideline, because I thought he was going to go out of bounds.
It's amazing. You don't realize how quiet the Rosewood fans have become until you see a good positive thing happen for the Eagles, and they get loud again. That's the way it's supposed to be.
Oh, yeah. Well, they're into it.
Do you really think I interrupt you too much? Two minutes and 21 seconds to go before this first half of great 1A football becomes history. Straight up the middle, Travis Holder picks up 4.
Travis Holder last week, I was looking at the white jersey. They wore the white with the dark pants.
It wasn't white at all. It was dirty. I know, I interrupted you. I did it on purpose, Artie.
No, you just, that's normal.
A minute and 48 seconds to go here in the first half. Second down and five now for the Rosewood Eagles. And with the ball and nowhere is John Reese. John Reese has stopped. No gain on the play. Is that the voice of the Eagles I hear?
Are you talking to me?
Are you not going to talk to
me? Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's Steve Smith, the voice of the Eagles. Rosewood has called a timeout.
We'll be back in just a moment. Oh, Daniels, yep. Recycle and save America's natural resources. If you see Tadpole, tell him thank you for bringing the Rosewood playoff games.
Well, we can do that. And also, you can thank Bobby Rex Carnegie.
Bobby Rex!
And Linda Carnegie. They want to congratulate all the folks in the Rosewood community, as well as Willie and Phyllis Sumlin from the Rosewood Food Liner.
A minute and 29 to go. Third down and a long four for the Rosewood Eagles. A full house backfield with Travis and John and all the guys. And guess what? John Reese is going to come up about a yard shy. They're looking at it, and I don't think they're going to bring in the measure because it's just not that close. They're going to bring the markers in, but I really don't think it's that close, are they? Do you?
No. But we have been wrong before.
They're a good 2 feet.
Yeah, at least.
Almost a yard.
At least.
A minute and 19 seconds remain to be played in the first half. Fourth down and a short yard to go.
Crowd is hollering go, and there's no doubt.
John Reese is out. Zach Gurley in the backfield. Along with Jeff Burnham. And the ball goes to Zach Gurley. He's got the first down.
Well, that was second effort. They got that first down.
Timeout is immediately called by the Rosewood Eagles with a minute and two to go. They've got a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
You know, this has been a really, really good series, and you know what you ought to do?
What?
I know that there are some people out there that probably would like to have some tapes of the playoff game, so you ought to consider putting together some kind of a package. You thought about that? I mean, I know people call and want a game, like after the first game they wanted or whatever. Some of them have tried to put the VCR on and
it never worked.
And it didn't work or whatever.
Well, actually, you don't really get a good quality either when you're taping it over the air like that.
Well, why don't you put a package together? You know, like the three playoff, and then if they go to Chapel Hill next week, a playoff package. Yeah.
Well, let's say this. Okay, folks, if you'd like to get.
Oh, you've already thought about it.
No, but I'm going to come up with a package right here.
Okay.
Let's say that we take the games and put them all on individual tapes, and we do the Rosewood-Columbia game, the North Duplin game, and tonight's game.
Okay.
Let's say that they're $12 a piece, or you can take one or all three. Okay, you can get one.
Oh, you're going to give a break. They're usually $15.
Well, I know that, but let's say they're $12 each, and you get all three. You get a set of three. For $36.
That's a good
one. Or if they go to the state championship game.
No, when they go next week.
When they go. Yeah. Right.
Okay. For $48, you get four tapes.
Right. Or for $36, if they happen to lose tonight, which I don't think is going to happen. And with the ball, this Travis Holder straight up the middle, picks up a couple.
That would be good. I was just thinking it would be good, to have, especially for the seniors.
Well, for the seniors, if somebody wanted to do it for the senior team, that would be great. How about for all the grandmamas and what a great Christmas greet. Now, I'm not sure I can get them ready for Christmas. I'll try. They're already made. I just have to duplicate them all.
You're about to put your foot in your mouth there.
No, we'll have it done. 38 seconds remain to be played. It is second down and eight. And with the ball is Eric firing.
He's open.
He's got a man up there. Runs a little bit too far.
Well, Whitley was open, but
And I think Rosewood is also fortunate because I saw a little movement in the backfield.
Yeah.
I think they're fortunate.
Could have been easily brought back.
Yep.
Yeah, that would be a good deal. I was thinking, you know, when the guy came up earlier and said he'd like to have a tape of the Columbia game.
You didn't say anything.
Well, I know, but it takes me a while to say something because I'm afraid you're going to jump in on top of it.
I usually do.
Anyway, if you'll, that would be good. Put together a package deal.
29 seconds to go. That's a good idea, Harvey. It really is. Eric Overby at quarterback. And he got in the run. And again, it's number 89, Wayne Boswell. This time, Wayne picks up only a couple of yards. And he's down at the 10-yard line. It will be fourth down. There are 21 seconds remaining to be played. And I think you and I both know what's going to happen. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Let's get it straight, folks. Here's the deal. Okay? Tapes are $12 each. We've got three series games. If you want all three series in a hardbound box with a rosewood cover, okay, and I can think
a rosewood cover.
Well, you know what
I'm
saying.
Are we getting fancy?
No, I mean, you know, it's a hardbound box, so they won't lose it and they won't get misplaced.
Yeah.
With that, and in fact, what we can really do is you see this program right here. We can take this program right. What is it? Yeah, and put it.
Well,
inside.
People are going to think that you already had this thing planned.
No, I don't.
Your wheels got the schedule.
Okay.
Your wheels go that way.
Right. And if you will call the office, you want to write the number down. It's not an 800 number now.
Call 1-800-EAGLES.
Right. No. If you will call Park Advertising at 735-9440. And tell Jane or tell Joe or whoever answers the phone, say, I'd like to get one of those rosewood packages. Then we'll have some idea how many we need to start making up if you'd like to get them before Christmas. They make a good Christmas gift. 21 seconds remain to be played. Let's go for the field goal, snap, spot, kick, and it looks like it might be off to the left side, and it is. It was close, Hardy. It was close.
I couldn't tell from here.
It had the leg behind it, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah.
It would have gone another 25 yards. We've got 15 seconds remaining in the first half, and we're going to get one of those delicious rosewood hot dogs at halftime. 15 seconds remain to be played, and the Red Barons will have maybe two plays, depending on whether they go by the air. If they decide to keep it on the ground, it's going to be one single play. It'll be first and 10, and they'll start from the 20-yard line. I don't mean to interrupt you, Artie. It's just my nature. Well, it shows a character flaw. It means I'm not listening to you. And I'll try to do better.
Well, according to Margo and Joe and Jane, you don't ever listen anyway. So
That's true. Number 22, I believe it was, right? Rodney Riddick, number 22. And the Red Baron say we've got 7 seconds remaining to be played in the first half. Let's take a timeout. It's an 8-6 ball game, and they really have absolutely nothing to lose at this point. Just let Devane Harvey, number 11, chunk it down the field. I mean, wouldn't you?
Well, I probably would not have, but, I mean, you know, they don't have anything to
lose. They really don't have anything to lose.
Well, they do. I mean, it could be intercepted. But anyway, it gives us an opportunity to talk about Neil S. Weeks Construction Company, and they're one of the sponsors for tonight. They want to congratulate the Rosewood football team, as well as Jim Vernon at Myco Supply.
Jeff, his son, has been playing right much.
Well, it's Judy's son.
Well, but they're both.
Yeah.
Jim and Judy.
We used to say Jim, and then Judy slapped me upside the head, and I said, no, it's Jim and Judy's son. Right. So, anyway, and as you mentioned, Dr. Joe Barber is also one of tonight's sponsors, as well as Brent King, your local nationwide insurance agent. And we appreciate the very fine
support. Yep. Yes, we do. Seven seconds remain to be played. Draw play up the middle. Picks up some good yardage. Knott. And again, they call timeout with 2 seconds. That's hard to believe that they really got that clock stopped, but they did. They're at the 35-yard line, and they'll have one more play.
One of the Rosewood fans hollered field goal. That would be good, huh?
Why not? Hardy, is there an empty seat in the house anywhere?
If there is, it would probably be...
Did you buy a ticket, by the way?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah, I sure did.
What's your number?
50-50. I'm not going to tell you.
My number is 570-5019. Call my number. Call my number. Oh, boy. 2 seconds remain to be played. I enjoy this press box. This is nice. Normally, we're outside.
It's a very nice press box. I'm sure the folks out at Rosewood would like to thank the county commissioners for passing off the money to put up the fence as quickly as possible. I think the Board of Education probably asked.
What fence?
You're so perceptive. The Rosewood field has new fences at both ends, the end zone.
Yep.
And, of course, it's for crowd control, and it was a good idea.
Absolutely, yeah. 2 seconds remain to be played, and you see an umbrella defense all the way. You can't really see it on those two cameras, but Rosewood is back deep. And a quick pitch goes back to number 24. He will be run out of bounds, and he is. There's no time left on the clock. Folks, we have a halftime with the score of the Rosewood Eagle Red Baron game at 8-6. It's really been a super first half, and we're going to go get a hot dog, but it won't seem that long to you because we're going to take one simple commercial break, and we'll be back with the Red Barons kicking off to the Rosewood Eagles to start the third quarter. We'll be back in just a minute.
More than 421 months ago, that's 35 years and some change, Howard Service Center opened at 2007 East Ash Street. Think about it. More than 35 years in the same location with many of Howard's 1956 customers still trading at 2007 East Ash Street. Howard's Service Center.
Make a donut stop at a Krispy Kreme shop. Get a fresh and plump and tasty. Make a donut stop at a Krispy Kreme shop and treat yourself today.
Fast Lube, 2516 East Ash Street, now offers you 20 vital lubricating services in just 10 minutes. Fast Lube uses only famous Valvoline oil products, from fleets to the family car. Fast Lube keeps your transportation operating at top efficiency. And remember, you're in and out in just 10 minutes at Fast Lube. And with Valvoline under the hood, you can count on thousands of trouble-free miles. Fast Lube, 2516 East Ash.
Heat is hard to beat, especially inside your car, with temperatures sometimes reaching 180 degrees in your car, and the sun's UV rays, which are very harmful to you and your upholstery. So what do you do about it? See the professionals at ProTint for window tinting. Block out UV rays, cool the interior, control annoying glare, and give your car that new look of elegance. ProTint's installers are factory certified, and every job carries a lifetime warranty. Get a free estimate today at ProTint.
You're doing good, Hardy.
Thank you.
I appreciate that. We didn't win, Hardy.
Oh, no, we didn't.
Steve Smith just called the number, and it was not my number.
Right.
I might have to talk to him about that. Folks, we're about to get this second half underway. If you've just joined us, it's an 8-6 lead for the Rosewood Eagles over the Red Barons from Gates County. Gates County scored on a pass interception return of about 45 yards. Other than that, I think Rosewood has pretty well dominated the game by keeping the ball on the ground and clock control. Exciting game for all the fans here. And it's a long way from over. 8-6 is our score.
Gates County was about to get a little steam rolling when they fumbled just before the end of the first half. So we'll see if they can get their machine cranked up. We hope not. Oh, nice kick.
Woo-wee. End over end. And Travis Holder will take it at the 5-yard line.
Nice
straight
hold
up the middle. Breaks one tackle. And he gets up over the 20-yard line. And a lot of that was just pure hard effort. He ran that back 20 yards. First and 10 for the Rosewood Eagles to start the third quarter deep in their own territory. Coming into the lineup is Reed Lewis, number one. First and 10 now for the Rosewood Eagles. It always takes a few minutes after getting a little cold drink in you to kind of settle it down. And we'd like to thank the water boy that came up?
The ball boy.
The ball boy. He came up, and we certainly appreciate his efforts. he was going to get us something to drink, and went down there, and the line was about 25 long, and he came back and says, fellas, I'm not going to have time to do it here at halftime. But the effort certainly is appreciated.
Oh, yeah. And if the folks at the concession stand didn't make any money tonight, they ain't never made no money. the game is going on, and they're still lined up probably about six or eight deep.
Good grief.
At the concession stand.
Pick up about 2 yards on that last play. It's second down and eight for the Rosewood Eagles to begin this third quarter of action. The home field belongs to the Eagles. Eric Overby quick pitches the ball back to number 37, and Zach Gurley picks up a first down as it gets up to the 39-yard line.
Well, just an ankle, and he'd have gone much further. It was a nice run by Zach Gurley. Of course, he got some good blocking. You got to give that offensive line credit. Up front, across the front line, Curtis Whitley, Jay Holland, Kevin Stafford, Jason Crocker, Jarrett Frazier, O.J. Capps, Reed Lewis, Jeff Fernan, those guys doing a good job.
Okay, first down, and with the ball is John Reese, and Reese gets back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play whatsoever. And you can see that Gates County is trying to fire up each and every member of the Gates County defensive staff. They know that Rosewood dominated the first half of this ball game by keeping the ball on the ground and continuing to pick up those first downs.
Well, it's good to see some enthusiasm, but it was probably real, real close to taunting.
Yeah, well,
they won't put up with that too much longer.
Straight eye formation for the Rosewood Eagles. Eric Overby waits, gives the ball up the middle, and Zach Gurley picks up five. It's close to the 45. They'll mark it at the 44, bring it back just a little bit. 9:45 and counting, third quarter. 8-6 our score. There's a camera down there. Maybe we could just wave and say hi. Jason Crocker, the center for the Rosewood Eagles. That's a job I really don't want.
That's a tough job.
Really, it's full house backfield for the Rosewood Eagles, and the ball goes to Reese, and Reese
fumbles,
loses it, and I believe that it's going to be recovered by the Red Barons. That ball never hit the ground as he spun around. He lost it, and the Red Barons will be in excellent field position at the Rosewood Eagle 46-yard line. And folks still have not settled back into their seats following going to the concession stand. A break for the Red Barons. They stop the Rosewood Eagles on the fumble, first and 10 now, with 9:05 to go, third quarter.
Matt Edwards, number 66, the young man that got the fumble.
Defense, the name of the game now for the Rosewood Eagles, first and 10. Devane Harvey gives the ball quickly, and he stopped cold. It was number 22, I believe, Hardy, Rodney Riddick. Rodney Riddick is stopped cold. Yeah. Gain on the play of only about a yard. Second down and 9 for the Red Barons.
Curtis Whitley made a nice tackle on that play. And the crowd trying to
fire him
get
up.
Get these Eagles fired up.
Devane Harvey, number 11, a pretty good quarterback. Quarterbacking the Red Barons, and a quick pitch goes to number 40. And Joseph Berra is not going to go anywhere. He's going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage. He may have picked up a half a yard, but folks, that's about it. 8:03 and counting.
Good pursuit by the Eagles. Wayne Boswell, Travis Holder, Eric Overby.
You know, there was something. Who else?
Go ahead.
No, I thought you were through, and it was a long pause. I'm trying my best not to interrupt you, but there was a long pause, and I thought that was it. And then I saw you searching for someone else, and I realized that I had stepped over you, and I tried not to do that.
You lie.
Third down at 8, and a little reverse, and he's going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage. Rodney Riddick got absolutely nowhere. They started this drive on the 46. They'll end the drive on the 45. Fourth down and 9.
Good effort that time. Jeff Vernon, Travis Holder, and I'll tell you, this really clogged the middle up. Wayne Boswell drops deep.
Number 89,
Eagles.
Back deep for the Eagles. You see him in the backfield back there. There goes the snap. He gets it away. And Boswell says, let it bounce one time. He says, I think I'll pick it up. He does. He's got a man right in front of him. He's going to go down at just about the 5-yard line, but I'm not sure he had much choice on that because I don't think the ball had enough momentum to go into the end zone.
I agree. I think he was trying to see if it was going to bounce up high enough to go in the end zone. It did not, so I don't think he did a wise thing.
Yeah.
First down for the Eagles. Of course, they're pushed back deep starting at their own 5.
6 minutes and 56 seconds remaining to be played in the third quarter. Rosewood backed up deep, 8-6. Critical set of downs now coming up for the Eagles. They need to get out of this hole. They've got wide receivers to both sides of the field, all spread out. Eric Overby gives the ball up the middle, and there's a little crease, but not much. Gets up to the 6, maybe the 7-yard line, and it is Travis Holder carrying the ball. Heard that Travis and a couple of the guys were really sore after the North Duplin game last week. They stayed in the whirlpool a long time to get over the soreness of an outstanding game between two top caliber teams, North Duplin and the Rosewood Eagles. And that was one of the best high school games that I've seen in a long,
absolutely,
long time.
You hadn't to see either team lose.
You really did.
It's a good ball game.
6:05 and counting, and Eric gives the ball quickly to, it looks like Reese, I'm not sure. Maybe
I thought it was
Zach. Gurley.
Maybe.
We'll wait, let get up. You're right, Hardy. It was Zach Gurley, 37. And we have a third down and 5 situation, and this is probably the most precarious that Rosewood has found themselves in a position of 3rd and 5 this deep in their own territory all night in this ball game. We're down to 5:39 and counting here in the third quarter. Need a loan?
Sure, always.
We'll call 735-3611. The folks at Kenmar Finance will be glad to help you. 3rd and 5 now for the Rosewood Eagles. It's up the middle, and Reese is not going to make it. I don't believe he picked up a couple of yards. It'll bring up a 4th and 3, and Rosewood will be forced to punt it away deep in their own territory. By the way, Standard Products?
Yeah.
Would like to say congratulations to the Rosewood Eagles. Win, lose, or draw, we love you from Standard Products.
Great.
They're a good corporate sponsor, aren't they? 4th down. And this punt will be coming from deep in the end zone. Hopefully it's a good snap. It is. He gets it away. It's a nice high driving kick, and it will be taken. And he drops it in. The Rosewood Eagles have recovered. There was no.
He did not call fair catch.
He did not call for a fair catch. I don't believe he did.
He did not. He absolutely did not. I can't believe that. And Wayne Bogwell, who has been around, I tell you, he has a nose for the football. He has been around all night long, as he was last week, intercepting that, picking off that pass.
How about calling the guys in the truck and see if they can catch that?
I'm sure they can.
Okay.
All right, he did not call for a fair catch, and then boom, nice hit by Williams. And then,
let's get back to action. A great break for the Rosewood Eagles. They got it 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. John Reese with the ball gets up to the 47-yard line.
Mike Williams put a hit on the Red Baron. And let's see, that was number 10.
Well, he actually never had possession of the ball. The ball hit him, and he never had control over it. And when he was hit, he had already lost the ball.
Oh, yeah, but he got a nice hit. That was number 10, Aaron Farah. But I can't believe he didn't call a fair catch because Boswell and Williams were right on top of him.
3 minutes and 45 seconds to go. Third quarter, 8-6 is our ball game. Quick pitch goes out to Zach Gurley, I'm sorry, and Zach. Where that Zeke
came Zeke
from.
And Zach, huh? Yeah, that's a good voice.
Third down and 5 right at the 50-yard line. A little less than 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. And I certainly would feel better if Rosewood could add a touchdown to their 2-point lead, a precarious lead. Wayne Boswell to the bottom of the screen, wide out to the left side of the screen, goes back, fires it to Wayne Boswell. He's got it! He may go all the way! He tries to get away from the man, cannot, picks up a good 25 yards, and you hear the crowd.
Well, Wayne Boswell got an excellent slanted pass, just slanted right across the middle, and Eric Overby hit him right on the fly. This did not have enough speed, though, to match with number 80, Jerome Knight. But a nice pickup. And Rosewood needed that shot in the arm.
I thought it was kind of pretty. Maybe after this play, we'll get to see Boswell on that completion, because it was a pretty play. First and 10 now with the ball at the 20-yard line for the Rosewood Eagles. Travis Holder, and the ball goes to Zach Gerlich. Now we show you that Wayne Boswell completion, if we can get gas the guys in the truck. Here it goes. There's the completion. See, one man has got the angle on him and brings him down right at the 20-yard line. But for Boswell, it was an awfully good run. Remember, this drive started at the 5-yard line, helped by the fumble of the fourth down punt. Second down, 7 for the Rosewood Eagles. Ball on the 17-yard line. John Reese cuts against the grain, gets over the 15-yard line to the 14.
Well, not much, as the Red Barons,
they're tightening up.
Tightening up a little bit.
Third and a long 4 now for the Rosewood Eagles. If you just joined us, we're late in the third quarter. It's 8-6 with the Rosewood Eagles over the Gates County Red Barons in the Eastern Championship game. The winner of this game gets to go to Chapel Hill next Saturday at 3:45 to take on the Western champion for the state title. A straight eye formation for the Rosewood Eagles. And Zach Gerlich says, let's fire it over. He's got it, and it may be. Hold on. Outside. Looks like he had it there for a minute, didn't
he? I know, it sure did. And the pass.
Wayne Boswell was, he was open for a minute, right?
He sure was. And, of course, the Red Baron showed up just about time the ball did.
I really, it's fourth down, and I really think that they are within the field goal range of the kicker. What do you think?
Well, I think they are, but
ball on the 14-yard line, I think.
Number three, Robbie Thompson, is not out there, or Thomas. So they're going for it.
Eric Overby says, let's go, and they can hear the Rosewood fans in the background. Hops it over the middle. It's going to be caught. Touchdown.
Well, Wayne Boswell was the recipient, and they're spotting the ball right at the 1-foot line, Jerry.
Funny, he fell across the goal.
Well, I'm blocked out right here, so I didn't see it.
Hey, fellas, you got you guys down in the truck. Can you cue that up for me? He fell across the goal. See if I'm right or wrong.
That was an excellent quick pass again. A little slant pass to Boswell.
Watch the ball right across the goal. Boom. See, he's over.
Sure did look like it.
Yep, 55 seconds remaining to be played here in the third quarter. 8-6 our score. Rosewood first and goal with the ball is Gerlich. Touchdown.
Well, Zach Gerlich made it look easy. So that puts the Rosewood Eagles on top. 14-6.
I believe I'd go for the single.
You would?
I sure would, because they can only go for 8. I mean, 2 extra, which would make it 14-15 if they go for the single point, and that's exactly what they're going to do. 14-6 our score. This will make the 15th point if good. Here comes the snap, the spot, the kick. Oh, it looks like it's going to be good.
Oh, it is good.
Yep.
Oh, that was close.
It eased across there. Folks, we have a 15-6 lead. That means a 9-point Rosewood Eagle lead.
That means the Red Barons got to score twice.
That's exactly right. 47 seconds remain to go in the third quarter, and we'll be back to Rosewood Field in just a moment.
Understand the true purpose of life insurance to be a success. Ray Batts, your Franklin Life representative, understands that life insurance...
Rosewood holds a 9-point lead. That's not a heck of a lot of points, and the Red Barons have not lost in 10 straight games. I'm sure they'll come back fighting. However, the Rosewood defense has played as well, if not better, than the Rosewood offense. The ball is taken on the 15-yard line. Tries to cut to the outside, finds a little crease, but that's all brought down on the 27-yard line.
That was number 25 for the Red Barons, Larry Elliott.
Again, the Red Barons have penetrated Rosewood territory one time, and that was on the pass interception. They have not crossed midfield to my recollection. Do you remember them crossing midfield?
No, I sure do not. Except for just a couple of plays. It's been all Rosewood. Of course, last time I said that, they got 15 yards. So
27 seconds remain to go here in the third quarter. 15-6 our score. And with the ball, number 40 breaks through, picks up 10, 11, 12.
I'm going to quit saying that. He got 12 this time.
Joseph Berra, the runner for the Red Barons. And again, you got to be proud of a team that lost three games, their opening three games of the season, and have come back to win 10 straight games, no matter what happens.
Well, look at the diversity they had. They had a brand new coach. They came in, 2-8 the year before. The conference coaches had picked them in the Albemarle Conference to finish last.
Straight up the middle, quarterback keeper, pick up of 5 yards.
So they have done a good job.
Absolutely. End of the third quarter, our score 15-6. We'll swap ends of the field and be back to Rosewood High School with the fourth and final quarter of this Eastern Championship game right after these commercial words.
We make it to go fast and we make it to last. From the racetrack in Talladega to the race to get it done, Unical is on the job because the job is number one. We make it to go fast and we make it to last. We make it to go fast and we make it to last. We got the lubricant for the job at hand. It's Unical, the best brand in the land. We make it to go fast and we make it to last.
The first name in appliances and televisions can be found at Orman's Appliance and Furniture. World-famous General Electric. Stoves, refrigerators, microwaves, stereos, and televisions can be yours at tremendous savings. Orman's Appliance and Furniture, located at 205 West Walnut Street, carries furniture for every room in your home. You will delight in both selection and low everyday prices. Shop Orman's Appliance and Furniture, 205 West Walnut Street, downtown Goldsboro. Orman's and General Electric. Names you can trust.
MC Hammer, rap star and Pepsi drinker. Well, today, we secretly replaced his Pepsi with Coke. Let's see what happens.
Feelings. Nothing more than feelings.
Hammer!
Proper.
Is that a high five or what? We're getting into it.
And there's Joe Sinicut Ham, our cameraman on the sidelines.
He does
a good job.
Sure does. As,
Rosewood is. You know what? You would think you would be cold, but you really aren't here.
Oh, no.
I mean, there's so much heat and enthusiasm coming from the crowd. It could be 25 degrees, and you
but we're
still
glad
have
it's
enthusiasm.
Not.
Yep.
We're glad it's not.
Second down for the Red Barons.
Well, what we are glad of is our fine sponsors like Waco Hands and Hudson Business Machines, Rosewood Ready Mart, North Carolina Salvage, Neil S. Weeks Construction Company, Myco Supply, Goldsboro Builders, Bobby Rex Carnegie, and Rosewood Food Line.
Also, Builders Discount Center. Don't forget them. We've got a second down and 5 at the 45-yard line. Man in motion for the Red Barons. Straight out of the middle. He's got a big hole. He's going to pick up a good 4 yards. It'll be third down and about a yard and a half. They're still shot. Again, it was number 40, Joseph Barra, doing the hard work for the Red Barons. Third down and about a yard to go. They need to cross midfield, and the ball is right at midfield. They need to cross midfield to pick up a first down, and it'll be one of the few times that they enter into the Rosewood territory. 11 and a half to go here in the fourth quarter.
Also, Dr. Joe Barber, Brent King, Hill and Ferentz, Kenmar Finance, and Standard Products. I'll tell you what, I don't think he made it.
I don't think he did. If where that referee's standing is where it's going to be marked, because he needed to get clearly over the 50-yard line, it will be fourth down, and still about a half a yard.
Well, they got to go for it, though.
I would think so, too. We've got right at 11 minutes to go, and there is no doubt they will go for it. And I don't know why they're measuring, Hardy. Right. It is obvious that it is a good foot and a half.
Well, it's because the quarterback has the option.
He's asked for it.
Yeah, he can do that.
Well,
while they're doing that, Wayne Realty and Insurance, Jeffrey Garden Center, Total Country, and Sasser Distributing.
You know,
those are our fine sponsors for this playoff game.
like to also mention something. You know, I see a lot of spirit wear. I see a lot of these rosewood jackets and rosewood hats and that kind of stuff. That makes great Christmas gifts too. So if you'll stop by Sportsman's World, one of our fine sponsors, and pick up a Rosewood Eagle sweatshirt, wouldn't you be proud to walk through the mall or just about anywhere in anything that's got the rosewood colors and rosewood on it? Make some great Christmas gifts. So think about Sportsman's World and go by and tell the folks that we sent you. Would they get them as a sponsor next year? You know, you're so know about those things. More than just inches. He's not going to make it.
He made it.
There's a flag. I think it's going to be illegal procedure.
Okay. Well, let's see.
Illegal procedure, the call. It'll be fourth down and almost six now. And I think the Red Baron's saying, now, do we want to go for it here?
I think they still got to go. They got to score they got to score two touchdowns.
Well, we got 10 minutes and 45 seconds remaining in the ballgame. That's still time.
Yeah, but...
And I would kick it, I believe.
Well, you said it after you saw the punt team come in.
Well, you're exactly right. You're not supposed to tell everybody. Don't tell everything you know.
But playing against a team that has ball control like Rosewood, I don't know.
Boswell's going back, number 89, back deep to receive for the Rosewood Eagles. And this could
be... this is not their regular punter, is it?
I don't think so. We'll have to wait and see. We'll see if it's a fake. Nope, it's legit, and he kicks a nice spiral. And Boswell just gets the heck away from it, which is a good idea, but he may get it before he goes in the end zone. He does not. It's a touchback, and the it was very close, and the Rosewood Eagles will take it on the 20-yard line. We've got 10 minutes and 30 seconds to be played in the ball game with a 9-point Rosewood lead.
Sounds good, and listen, I'm going to hold you to it now. I'm not going to let these folks down. I mentioned in the first half about putting a package together of tapes for these ball games. So I want you to stay on top of that.
No, I said I would do it. Now,
okay.
We'll do is that we've got three games.
It's normally $15 a tape. You can let them have for $12.
Right.
All right.
We'll give you all three games at $12 per game.
Plus next week if they make it. They make it.
Right,
excuse
right.
me.
So if they do, and we'll try to have them all ready by Christmas time. How's that? Up the middle, a pickup of about 3 yards. And what that means is, let's say we did the Columbia game.
You gotta go to work.
No, it means I gotta do a lot of work.
Yeah.
The Columbia game, a good clean copy of the Columbia game.
Right.
And a good clean copy of the North Duplin game.
Right.
And a good clean copy of the Red Baron game with Gates County. And if Rosewood comes out on top, then we've also got the state championship game. Now,
which will probably be what, Murphy?
Right. So if you wanted all four as a fourth set, it would be $12 a tape or $48. If you want three, then it would be $36. You can figure it out. And with the ball is Zach Gurley. He's going to be brought down hard.
And, not
and,
much.
And what it boils down to is if you want all four at $12 per game, $48. You know, but you need to call early to place your order.
And so in other words, if you want four tapes, that's $12, $12, $12, $12.
Right. and we'll give you the hardbound box. You know those boxes that we
give you the Crime Stoppers.
Crime Stoppers.
Yeah.
Those hardbound white boxes we can put the rosewood letters on them and all that stuff.
They'll
be pretty, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. It'd make good gifts for the football team.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Call 1-900.
No, we don't have a
draw play to Travis Holder. Travis Holder in the open picks up the first down, gets up to the 47-yard line.
Now people are going to think you got a 900 number, and you shouldn't say that.
I don't have, folks. I really don't have a 900 number. In fact, I'm so far into Goldsboro, I'm still 735. if you want to call
1-800-ROSEWOOD.
Call 1-800-ROSEWOOD. No, if you'll call 735-9440, Jane or Joe or just anybody to answer the phone, just tell them.
Which will probably be Jane.
Yeah, Jane will probably answer the phone and say, Jane, I'd like to get all four tapes, and she'll take your name and that kind of stuff, and you tell her whether you want to come by and pick them up or whether you want to have them mailed and that kind of stuff.
It would probably be a good idea this week. You know, I mean, we know Rosewood's going to go next week.
Yeah, it doesn't matter whether they win or lose.
So you know there's going to be a tape. So what you do now is you call and go ahead and reserve a tape.
That's right, First and 10 for the Eagles. Quick pitch goes back to Zach Gurley. Going to be dropped in the backfield.
Not much at all as
Red. Well, see, the problem now for the Red Barons is that Rosewood is keeping it on the ground.
Yeah.
And we're under 9 minutes. We've got
very
8 minutes.
Very much ball control.
Yeah, and they're playing ball control. You got to remember that the Red Barons must score twice. It'll take a touchdown and a field goal to make nine, a touchdown, an extra point, and a field goal to surpass the 15 points on the board that Rosewood has. And as long as Rosewood has the ball, none of that's going to happen. Second down and 12, straight up the middle. It's Travis Holder. Travis Holder about had his arm ripped off. Manages to get over the original line of scrimmage and pick up an additional yard.
Well, what the Red Barons are doing is they're trying to tackle the ball, and they're trying to strip the ball. And you're right, Travis was being pulled in all directions.
And also would like to remind you that, as you know, the state charges a rather healthy extra fee to do these games, and some of the folks that have helped us along, like Builders Discount Center, locations in Wendell, Wallace, Rocky Mountain, Burlington, they came by and said, we want to help. Suppliers of all your building needs at discount prices. They'd like to congratulate the players, the coaches, the band, the cheerleaders, the fans, and me and Hardy.
Sounds good. And Jesse Paul and Peggy Sasser, also one of the fine sponsors, and they also congratulate the Rosewood Eagles. And they were sponsors of our Christmas parade.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
And, in fact, they rode in the Goldsboro Christmas parade with a golf cart.
Yeah, right. And Jesse Paul wanted me to remind everybody. He told Jane, he said, remind everybody that we have a brand-new location. It's right down from Sasser Distributing, and it's right down the street.
Oh, I've seen those golf carts. Man, he must have 100 of them out there.
Really does.
Yep, and I'm sure he'd like to sell some right here at Christmas time. That would be good.
Yeah.
And, of course, also Total Country at 1105 South George Street is one of our sponsors, Jeffrey's Garden Center. And if you're looking at a Christmas tree, go see Andy Lewis at Jeffrey's Garden Center.
Now, I got my tree at Jeffrey's.
Yeah, I did, too. And they offer delivery.
Yeah, they offer free delivery.
Free delivery, yeah.
In other words, if you go by...
In town. Free
if
delivery.
You go, well, Rosewood counts as in town.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, oh, yeah.
If you go by Jeffrey's Garden Center and just tell Andy, say, look, we watched the Rosewood game.
We need a Christmas tree.
We need a Christmas tree.
But you better hurry.
Oh, yeah, they're beautiful.
Oh, yeah, and they get picked over real quick.
Yeah. Beautiful trees. Folks, we're down to 7 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in this Eastern Championship game. Straight eye formation. Travis Holder up the middle and did not pick up the first down. It'll be fourth down and about 5. And the Eagles, I would punt it away at this point.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
In one of the games that Rosewood lost early in the year, they lost a game. Let's see if I can remember who the game was with. I think it was. Well, I don't see it on there.
Well, they got.
Oh yeah,
Hobson.
It was Midway.
Okay.
And they were leading Midway by a score of 21-7 late in the ball game, and Midway came.
All right.
Oh, that's a tough break for the Red Barons.
Yeah, that's a 5-yard penalty.
Right. Depending on.
Still will not give them a first down.
It might. Hardy, look at the marker. It's going to be awfully, awfully close.
Yeah. It'll be a yard short.
You think so? It looks like to me they'll make it. If they mark off 5 yards over there, and I guess the way you could do that is you take the chain and swing it around.
Shadow.
Yeah. See it?
Yeah, I see it.
I mean, 5 yards would give them a first down, and the logical thing to do would just be take the chain and swing it around and see if 5 yards extends past that. That would be the logical thing to do. Don't you think?
You're talking logic. That's a first. Yeah, that's a first. That's a first.
Well, I think it's a first, too, but all you have to do is if he holds the chain right there, and I see what they're going to do. They're going to bring it out, and they'll fold the chain over. I think they're going to do the logical thing, Hardy.
Well, they're not going to turn the chain around, if that's what you're talking about.
Okay, they'll lay that there, and then they will. That's the only way they can tell if it's half the chain, though. What? Now, that's not half.
One, two, three.
I tell you what.
Did you see those steps?
Yeah, but let me tell you something. That referee is like me. He's got short legs, okay? And when he started, the Rosewood fans counted with him. And he got one, two. It got louder and louder. And that last step was like, wow.
He pulled a growing muscle on it last week.
Yeah. Well, it was a first anyway.
It was a first. They just didn't do it the way I would have done it.
No. Well.
If the chain is exactly 10 yards, right?
I tell you, he'd have had some upset people up here. Oh, me.
We've got 6 minutes and 53 seconds.
The officials
seconds.
Do a good job.
They really do.
I'm telling you, they do a great job, and they catch a lot of flack.
First
they do a good
10
job.
For Rosewood, and with the ball, going nowhere, Zagerman.
No, that was John Reese.
Oh, was it? Was that 23?
Yeah.
You're right. Can you see these players, Hardy? You and I have watched a many a high school game. Can you see these players, you know, with their kids around 25 years from now and looking at this game on tape?
Yeah, and the kid says, "We got to watch it again."
But, Daddy! Second down and 10, and with the ball is Travis Holder. And Travis Holder now has four kids, and he's on his third marriage. Third down now, and let's call it about 6 yards to go for the Rosewood Eagles.
I tell you what, Travis has learned to run almost on the ground with one hand, you know, just crawling on the ground. He gets so low, and of course that's the way he picks up a lot of yardage. Good runner. We're really getting some good blocking on that offensive line. Those guys are still in the fourth quarter, still firing off, getting good blocks.
Five and a half to go in the ball game. Quick pitch goes out to John Reese, the freshman. He's got a little bit of running room.
Oh, he fumbled the ball.
It goes out of bounds. And it goes out of bounds. So it remains Rosewood's ball. And the ball bounced forward. And it may be close enough for another Rosewood first down.
I think it rolled across the yard marker. And I almost believe he rolled for a first down.
Well, that would be a great break for the Rosewood Eagles. And again, the only points on the board for Gates County was that pass interception.
Well, the ball was stripped away from John, and luckily for Rosewood, it rolled forward and out of bounds, and it's a first down. Man,
they'll mark it off. And there's nothing, and that's it. It's just a lucky break for Rosewood on that particular.
Oh, absolutely. Well, you got to have that. You got to be a good football team, and you got to have a lot of good breaks to get this far.
Can't you see in 25 years about
did we do this a while ago?
No, 300 people, 300 of the guys from Rosewood High School all bought this tape, and they all claim to be number 15. How's that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
First and 10 now for the Rosewood Eagles at the 42-yard line of the Red Baron. With the ball, Gurley gets to the 40.
Not much. As Zach kind of danced around a little bit. Picked up a little bit of yardage.
If the folks do everything we've asked, they're going to buy Christmas trees from Jeffries, and they're going to get some Rosewood sportswear from Sportsman's World, and they're going to buy the series of tapes. You know, what else are they going to do?
Well, they're going to go by and see Bob Logan at Wayne Realty and Insurance. They're going to ride there on a golf cart by Sasser Distributing Company. And then, of course, they're going to get a little Total Country.
That's right, and they go buy some groceries from Rosewood Food Liner. And they go get a loan to pay for all this from Kenmar Finance. And with the ball, it is John Reese. And again, now it is the clock that is the main enemy of the Gates County Red Barons, because as it looks right now, it looks more and more like a trip next weekend for the Rosewood Eagles to Chapel Hill.
Looks good. Standard Products, another one of our fine sponsors, Hill and Ferentz, June and Fred Hill. Say congratulations to these folks. Brent King, your local nationwide insurance agent, along with Dr. Joe Barber.
And don't forget Bobby Rex Carnegie, who is Chester Thompson's number one fan.
And Linda Carnegie.
Right. Linda's not that crazy about Chester. Straight up the middle, he may have a first down.
I think he's going to put where his knee hit.
Well, that'll leave him shot.
That'll bring him back a little bit.
3.5 minutes to go in the ball game. What a great ball game for Rosewood this will be.
Also, Goldsboro Builders, Myco Supply, Neil Weeks Construction Company.
How about Rosewood Ready Mart?
Yep, Rosewood Ready Mart. Hudson Business Machine, Waco Hands, and Builders Discount Center.
And Al Strickland, who is a loyal Rosewood Eagle fan.
Oh, really?
He really is.
Oh, you mean that was actually an eagle tattooed on his forehead?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. It wasn't one of those bubblegum tattoos.
Fourth down and about a yard to go for the Rosewood Eagles. Oh, they've got an offside. It will be an illegal procedure will be the call against the Eagles, which will be fourth down now and about seven. But really with an even 3 minutes to go, even Steven, 3 minutes to go, a 15-6 lead, the ball being brought back to the 38-yard line or thereabouts. We'll see where they put it. About the 38, though, I think. I still would keep the ball. I wouldn't kick it. So what would you do?
Well, I'd keep the ball, too, because if they kick it, it's going to probably go in the end zone anyway and bring it out to the 20, which would only give you about, 18-yard advantage. So, well, some of the fans are hollering kick the ball, but I wouldn't kick the ball.
Fourth down, you want the clock to run. It's got 2 minutes and 45 seconds to go. You're up by 9 points, and you're going back, and Eric says, catch this, fella.
And he did.
It's going to be incomplete. He trapped it, Art.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Okay.
The ball was trapped on the ground. So, with 2.5 to go, the Red Barons have their work cut out for them. They're down by 9 points, and I'm sure this last 2 minutes and 37 seconds will go by excruciatingly slow because we will see the quarterback, Harvey, is that his name?
Yeah, Dwayne Harvey. Devane Harvey, excuse me.
Devane, is that it?
Devane Harvey.
Devane Harvey.
Devane Harvey.
He'll be putting it in the air with regularity. And Rosewood will be playing just a prevent defense. They won't mind if they pick up 5-6 yards. Maybe even a couple of first downs will be fine. Wide receivers out wide to the right and left for the Red Barons. Going back, he's got that smooth delivery. Fires it. It's going to be incomplete. Actually, number 44 should have had the ball. Patrick Riddick should have caught that ball. Yeah. He had a great opportunity, but he turned before he had possession of the ball and just went out of bounds. It just stopped the clock, and that's all it did. Second down and 10 now for the Red Barons. And I think we'll just listen to the crowd a while.
Well, you look again for a pass, and, of course, Devane Harvey did not disguise at all what he was going to do on the last play.
Oh, no. And he's smooth with the ball. Goes back, settles down, fires it, incomplete, third down.
Pass intended for number 24, Kelsey Evans, but it was behind him.
And Zach Gurley was right on top of the play.
Takes the clock down to 2:25. And, of course, Rosewood on top, 15-6.
The big R in the center of the field stands for ready to go to Chapel Hill.
That's pretty good. Well, this crowd is ready, and I'm sure that there will be a number of folks in Chapel Hill.
Third and 10, 2:25 remaining in the ball game. The Red Barons go back again, and he's getting the pressure. Going to be brought down to the 30-yard line, a loss of 10. And Travis Holder has played an outstanding game and an outstanding series, both on offense and defense. And I know his parents are extremely proud of him.
Absolutely. And clock as you know, rolling. Travis is, 5'10", 180-pound junior.
And although it is fourth down and 20, the Red Barons have absolutely nothing to lose. If they kick it away, they've admitted defeat. They may kick it away.
Well,
but I think they will throw one more pass.
They're
going to
try something. Yeah, they've called a timeout to talk about it.
Tell you what, let's take a time in for these commercial words, and we'll be right back.
I was expecting the fans to start chanting, Chapel Hill, Chapel Hill, you know.
Fourth down. And 20 yards to go. Devane Harvey fires it. Intercepted.
Well, actually, he'd have been better off to knock that one down.
Well, come to think about it, yeah, but you don't think about that.
Oh, no. They want Murphy, and I think that's probably who they'll get. At the halftime, it was 20-0, Murphy over East Montgomery.
Well, Murphy's tough, but you know,
yeah,
Murphy,
I know it.
Murphy is probably 300 miles from here.
I'm glad they're playing in Chapel Hill.
I know. Folks, there's a minute and 34 seconds remaining to be played in this ball game, and the Rosewood Eagles will be the Eastern champ. Means they've taken care of Southwest Onslow that was undefeated. They've taken care of North Duplin. They were undefeated. A minute and 23 seconds remain to be played, and Rosewood will be the Eastern champion.
That's great. You mentioned Southwest Onslow. Not only were they unbeaten, but they were number one ranked in the state.
In fact, four or five teams had not even scored on them.
Right.
And Rosewood went down there at their place.
Yep, beat them 14-12. That was a good ball game. 14-10, beat them a good ball game.
Delay a game, the call against the Rosewood Eagles.
Of course, then he came back and beat Columbia 28-0. Then last week at North Duplin. And now this week against the Red Barons. So they're on to Chapel Hill.
Remain focused, guys.
Chapel Hill, they finally started.
Chapel Hill.
Well, as they're hollering Chapel Hill, Travis Holder.
He comes close to a first down. He picked up the lost plus 10, close to 15 yards, but he's going to be just shy, I do believe, of a first down. It will be second down in just inches.
Yeah, they started that Chapel Hill chant. I knew it would come in a minute. You hear it?
57 seconds is all that remains between Rosewood and Chapel Hill. U.S. 15, look out, because it's going to be a busload or two headed to the Chapel Hill University of North Carolina field.
Absolutely.
Be the first time that purple has been in that field in a long time. Last time purple and gold were in that field.
That was the Danny Kepley days, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Well, the last time, East Carolina beat, UNC 37-17.
Something
and Carolina
like
says,
oh, we can't play anymore. We're not going to play anymore.
Take our ball and go home.
Only 57 seconds remain to be played in the ball game, and we're going to hold it right here. There's no sense in going anywhere else, and hope you're getting a chance to see a lot of the crowd.
Branch Pope
and all
is.
The. You want Branch?
Talk
you,
to
you want to talk to us, Branch? Right after
the ball game.
Branch, come in. Give me a second. You know.
Tell us, Branch, what this means to the athletic program at Rosewood High School.
Hardy, we're real pleased. Joe and the coaches have done a heck of a job, and all these kids are overachievers. And to get to the state championship game is a once-in-a-lifetime dream. It looks like we're going to be there.
Well, it's great. And I'll tell you one of the things I was really, really impressed with this week when Joe said that the team was focused. They absolutely knew what they had to do. They practiced hard. He didn't have a problem with them during practice. They knew exactly what they had to do.
We're all fine young men. We're proud of every one of them. We really are. And we're going to go over and see what we can do with Murphy next week.
Well,
I'm looking forward to
it. I know you are, and we want to thank you and, of course, the Principal Williams and all your staff for having us out here. It's been great.
We appreciate y'all coming out, and it's great. And I think y'all do a great job for high school athletics and high school sports here in Wayne County. We're looking forward to having y'all in Chapel Hill.
We're looking forward to going to Chapel Hill up there with the big guys on real television.
Okay, thank you a lot.
Thank you. That was Athletic Director Branch Pope.
First down is picked up by the Rosewood Eagles. And they're just driving. Of course, the heart has gone out of the Red Barons. They know they've lost the game. And what we're doing is really, well, it's elementary because the clock is ticking along with 44 seconds to go. The Eagles have it first and 10. They're at the 30-yard line. There is no sense in scoring again. And I really can't see Joe McCullough.
Well, he's not because he's got.
He's got one man back deep just to hold it.
John Reese, 20 yards back.
32 seconds to go, and I'm sure they will just down the ball. And that's exactly what they do, which is a great sports approach to the ball game. The ball game has been over now for about 2 or 3 minutes, and we've got 21 seconds remaining to be played in the ball game.
We congratulate, as I said before, all the folks out here at Rosewood and the fans. We want to congratulate you because the support that you have given the Rosewood athletic programs, your baseball,
listen,
all your
listen,
sports.
Listen,
well, it's over. Champs.
There you have
yeah.
The Eastern champs, the Rosewood Eagles, and you talk about a happy bunch. You could just look for yourself.
That is a happy bunch, and as you said, they are the champions of the East, and they will go on to Chapel Hill next week at 3:45 in the afternoon, Saturday afternoon, to play probably Murphy. We are not sure right now, but they were leading 20-0 at the halftime over East Montgomery. So, Jerry, I would think that would be who they would possibly play. We get to go to Chapel Hill. How about that? In the big press box.
I hope so. Everything. Frank says, I want to see you guys immediately following the game. I certainly hope we get to it. And again, remember what we said about the tapes, if you'd like all three or all four now.
All four, that'll be four tapes.
What a heck of a collection.
Oh, that'll be nice. It really
call
will.
The office so we can buy some tapes and get some stuff going, because I'm sure you'd like all four of the tapes. So, for Hardy Sullivan, this is Jerry Parker, and we certainly have enjoyed it, and we'll see you next weekend from Chapel Hill.